911. What are you reporting?
We got someone or something crawling around out here.
Did you see what it was? Was it a person or an animal or?
I can't tell. All I know is that my sensor light came on and I just happened to glimpse and see this thing running across the yard. A good sized man or something, looks like a man. I don't know what it was. Just it ran across the yard.
Okay. You've had problems in the neighborhood before?
Yeah, my dog was killed here just recently. I don't know what it was. Whatever it is, it's running. I couldn't catch it if I was going to chase it. So whatever it was, it was standing up. I'm out here looking through the window now and I don't see anything. I don't want to go outside. Somebody out here.
What's going on now, sir?
That son of a bitch is about 6'9". I don't know.
Do you see him now, sir?
Yes.
You're listening to Paranormal 411. Coming to you live from an undisclosed location deep within the Appalachian Mountains. Bringing you the unknown with your hosts David Reagan and Jason Scott. Paranormal 411.
All right, welcome.
Welcome back, everybody. We've got someone in the chat room that we haven't got to see in a while. Miss Sherry Perry, how you doing? Nice to see you back.
Oh, yeah. Hello, Sherry.
So, want to say that we are live on Spreaker and on Podbean, but you could also come to paranormal411.org, sign up, become a member, because it's free.
Yes.
Right, Jason?
Totally free.
Totally free. Don't cost a dime. You can ask Sherry. She'll tell you. But she is one of our premium members.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. But you can come into our live show and chat room and chat with us in there. Shell's in the room also. So come chat with us. And but you can also come on to Spreaker and on Podbean and chat with us also. Right, Jason?
Oh, yeah.
We're in both places.
We're chatting.
We're chatting away. So we have a new book out. It's a nice little coffee table book, right, Jason?
Yep.
You can find it on Amazon. You could search for East Tennessee Hauntings and Lore, or you could look up our names. Like I said, it is a great little coffee table book. It just has some few personal, couple personal stories and some local stories and some East Tennessee stories in it. It's a nice little read. We got 5 stars.
5 stars.
People love us.
5 star. 5 star foot long. Or it's $5 foot long.
$5 foot long. Well, we might get in trouble for playing that. They might try to sue us or something.
Tonight we're going to be talking about the lost city of Atlantis.
Ooh. I love talking about Atlantis.
What about it? Is it really lost?
Did it just take off? Was it a?
No, that was a movie, or that was Stargate Atlantis. Wonder how close that movie is to that.
I would say probably pretty close.
Yeah,
maybe. We'll see.
You know, but
one of these days, I think we'll find out.
Yeah. First, we got to. Do a little, which one is it?
I think it's that one.
Yeah.
Yep.
This Day in History with David Reagan.
Wow. Woo, listen to those accolades. Thank you, Jason.
You're welcome.
So today is June 24th, 2022. Can you believe it?
Yeah.
We're already at the end of June. So on this day in 1947, American businessman Kenneth Arnold saw a number of objects flying like saucers while piloting a small plane over Mount Rainier in Washington. It was considered the first modern sighting of UFOs and also gave rise to the term flying saucer. That pretty cool, huh? Also on this day in 1497, go way back now, John Cabot became the first European to set foot in North America since the Vikings.
Mmm.
Skull. And that's just a few things that happened on this day in history.
Was that the Mayflower or what was it?
Oh, that's way before the Mayflower. Yeah, that's when
John
the Spanish...
Cabot.
Yeah, I'd say that's... Yeah. Because I don't think that that's even the ones that went missing.
Yeah.
Because I think that's way before them.
All right.
But, you know, in the 1400s, the... also when all the Spanish and all that stuff started coming in, so hitting the South America and all that. So how you doing today, Jason?
Pretty good.
Yeah?
How about you?
I'm doing good. Ready for this topic. I like talking about, you know, when it comes to Atlantis and all that stuff, you know, Atlantis, Lemuria, and were they really aliens? Were they, what were they, you know? I think that's what they are.
Yeah.
We don't know.
We do not know.
But let's go on a journey.
A journey. To another dimension.
That's it.
A dimension not only of sight, but of sound. Your next stop. The Paranormal Zone.
You know, we tried to name it that, didn't we?
Yeah.
But it's already taken. That sucks.
Hey, we're going to take a... Whoa.
Didn't expect that, did you?
A quick break to get in here before we start the topic out.
Yes. We sure are. So remember, you can find us on Podbean and on Spreaker live, but you could also come to Paranormal 411.
I hope we're live.
If we're not, we're in trouble.
Maybe we're dead.
Hey, wouldn't that be cool? We're dead podcasting. Dead casting. We started a whole new genre, Jason. We are dead casting. We're going to tell you what it's like from the other side. We're going to be in the upside down. Right, Jason?
Yeah, we may be soon.
Yeah.
Oak Ridge is blasting it over.
Trying to get us there, huh?
Yep.
Open up a dimensional portal. That's a freaky thing to think about.
Yep.
But you could also check us out in our live chat room on paranormal411.org. Sign up, become a member. It is free. It doesn't cost a dime. Is that right, Jason?
No, it don't cost a dime.
Nope, it's $2 a month. No, I'm just kidding.
Checks payable, Jason Scott. Thank you.
Please do not bounce them. No.
Lord.
But definitely, you are listening to Paranormal 411, and your host tonight is, as always, Jason Scott and David Reagan, and we will be back after this quick break.
In a world on the edge of oblivion, go to paranormal411.org for all of your paranormal, extraterrestrial, and cryptid needs.
Thanks for listening to the show. You can find us on Facebook and Twitter at Paranormal411. Join us on the website at paranormal411.org. It's free to sign up and become a member. All of our upcoming shows are on the guest and events page. You can also listen to past shows on the website as well. And if you like the show and want to support us, you can do that by becoming a premium member for only $2 a month. Thanks for listening to Paranormal 411. Join us.
This is Jeff Reagan of the band Catalyst. Visit Paranormal 411. Click on our link on the right-hand side to listen to or purchase any of our albums on BandLab.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Right. We're back.
Oh, yeah. After that quick little break.
Nice quick break. So, Jason.
Yes.
We're talking about Atlantis.
Atlanteans.
Now, do you think of it kind of like how Stargate did it?
No.
No?
No, I think it was a thriving civilization on an actual island.
Yeah.
How about you?
I definitely think, you know, everything, when you start looking it up, you don't only have Plato's tale of it and everything, but you have where Plato says he got it from, right? Which is his grandfather, and he got it from the Egyptians.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of people were going, well, we've never seen it anywhere in Egypt, and yet they think that they have found it, the tale of Atlantis in Egypt. So I don't know. I just think that maybe it was something that was so old, a lot of people just forgot it. Forgotten history, like what we're used to dealing with anyway, you know?
Yeah.
I think we have, we've definitely forgotten who we are, where we come from, and all of that.
Well, I mean, this story hadn't got any less, it's gained popularity over 2,300 years.
Right.
I mean, it's not forgotten. Nobody's forgotten about this. It's one of the oldest and greatest mysteries in the world.
Yeah, I think so.
You think it was real?
I do.
Who do you think built it?
Well, if it's Atlantis, I would say the Atlanteans, but...
Poseidon, maybe?
Maybe. I mean, you know, I think that there's a possibility that a lot of these so-called gods came down. I mean, that's what Ancient Aliens has made a career. What are they, 19 seasons or something like that?
I don't know.
I mean...
They're way up there.
They've made a career out of, you know, showing us what could be. And who knows, right? It's very possible. Today we call them aliens, and back then they called them gods.
Yeah. I call them humans from the future.
Yes, time travel.
Maybe, you know, it's just a thought.
I like that thought process.
So where is this mysterious location at? Huh?
People are still trying to find it.
Yeah. Well, the narration suggests that the city is believed to have sunk into the sea after an earthquake or tsunami. Mm-hmm. The so-called Atlantis was a large island located near the Rock of Gibraltar and consisted of a Poseidon temple and concentric walls and canals.
Yes.
So where's the Rock of Gibraltar?
The rock, that is out past, let's see, if I'm not mistaken, I'm going to have to look this up so then I'm not lying to people, but I'm more than sure. That is out past the Black Sea into the ocean. Let's see. It's a monolithic limestone located in the British territory of Gibraltar near the southwestern tip of Europe and on the Iberian Peninsula. And it is near the entrance. And now my internet stopped working. And that's the way it goes. Let's see here. Yeah, the Mediterranean Sea. That's where it is. It's right at the entrance of the Mediterranean Sea.
Sherry wants to know, is there documentation, like ancient documents of Atlantis?
Yes.
I think all I know is of Plato writing about it, and he got the story from his grandfather.
Who got it from?
Who got it from the Egyptians?
Egyptians. And I think, hold on a second, and I'll tell you.
David thinks the Egyptians have just uncovered the story in some of their writings.
Yes. Let's see here. Yeah, they just made a discovery not that long ago. And let's see. I'm trying to remember exactly what it was that they what they discovered and where it is, because it's actually located in a temple. And it is not called Atlantis. It's called something else, but the tale of it is identical.
A utopian island.
Yes.
Where everything's free and wild and happy.
Yes. Egypt's Atlantis is called the Lost City of Thonius Herculean is the name of it. So if you want to look that up, Thonius Herculean, and I'll actually put it into the chat room here. There we go. And now it's in the chat room.
Mm-hmm.
You could go ahead.
So, what do you think?
Well, I think that, you know, when you finally, you know, a lot of people were like, oh, well, you know, there's no proof of his grandfather getting it from, you know, these people and stuff like that. Was that what?
I think you've been watching too many movies.
You're into that MCU universe there.
Yeah.
Yeah, buddy.
Aquaman did come from Atlantis in the movies.
Yeah, he did. It was sunk at that time, though.
On the bottom of the ocean.
That's it. Davy Jones Locker. but like I was saying, you know, with the stuff that they found of the Lost City and stuff, and that they're actually starting to find more tales of it outside of, you know, Plato's tale, that there's going to be more people looking for it. Because it exists somewhere. And if it's at the bottom of an ocean or something, you know, it's just going to be really hard to find.
Yes.
Because tectonic activity usually at the bottom of the oceans are a lot worse than above them.
So Plato's legend says that the Atlantean city was built by Poseidon, the god of the sea.
Yes.
The god of storms and earthquakes. Mm-hmm. It says that he fell in love with a mortal woman, and he made this city on top of a hill on an isolated island in the sea to protect her, and named it Atlantis. Hmm. According to the story, Poseidon walked through the world in an effort to find the biggest island until he reached the biggest of them all, and found it to be inhabited by people who were more beautiful and intelligent than the rest of the world. It was then that he fell in love with, I can't pronounce her name, Plato, when he finds her on the island. So, what do you think?
You know, where they talk about how it is, you know, it's concentric circles and canals and all of that, right with a, right on the ocean. So ships could come in and out of, cause it was a trading place. And I'll tell you what's really funny is with us doing a lot of the research and stuff that we've done, a lot of people have,
Amber turd.
That's it. I wonder why they've never looked at Mexico City.
I don't know.
Because, you know, before the Spanish took it over, it was concentric circles with canals. Some of those canals still exist today. Attached to the ocean. And then the Spanish come in and buried a lot of that up and stuff. But, you know, I would really like to see what it looked like then, because it actually had temples. A lot of those temples still exist in Mexico City. And
I thought Mexico City was like in the middle of Mexico.
Was it? I think it's on, well, pretty close to the ocean.
It may be. I'm not sure.
You know what? Before I keep talking, you keep talking, and I want to look this up.
You was talking about...
it's actually south of Mexico City where we was talking about the Island of the Dolls.
Yeah.
There. Okay. Because that was once all...
Well, they said that it was surrounded by rings of water and land. Five rings of water were connected to the land with the help of five tunnels, where a huge canal connected the outer rings of water to the ocean. So the tunnels were able to accommodate ships, and every route to the city, which was guarded by gates and towers. The wall that surrounded the rings was built using red, white, and black rock and was decorated with precious metals. And there was another hill called the Hill of Cleto, where it is believed Poseidon captivated his wife because he was distrustful of her loyalty. This hill was surrounded by huge moats and pillars. So, is Atlantis real? Bird Dog says temples ain't nothing. I got two of them. Where are they at, Bird Dog?
On the top of his head.
On the sides of his head.
I say he's Atlantean. Remember, I think they're on the top of his head.
Oh, yeah. He's Aquaman.
That's it. You're going to have to come over and show me this Aquaman ability in the swim pool. City, Mexico.
So other than the legend of the lost city of Atlantis, the fact about the city still remains unknown. Among historians and other researchers, the findings of Edgar Cayce had something different to tell.
Oh, yeah.
Edgar Cayce believed in the rising of the lost city. Once again, like the sun rises from the sea, he predicted a new land would appear off of the east coast of North America.
That's Bimini, right?
Yeah. He also suggested that the souls of a number of people lived in Atlantis had been incarnating to America in order to usher in a new era of enlightened human consciousness. So they were incarnating the souls from Atlantis in America, waiting to go to their island when it rose up out of the ocean, right? What?
Extraterrestrials.
Extraterrestrials.
What do you think?
Bird dog swims naked, David. Do you remember?
Oh, my Lord. No, I don't remember because I've never seen you swim, so I don't remember, bird dog. I can't say that I remember.
You know a lot about Edgar Casey, right?
You know, I do know quite a bit. You know, I do know that he had a hell of a gift, and he was able to put himself under trance, and he did. I mean, there's volumes of works, you know, that he cited, and Atlantis was some of them. The library that's supposed to be under the Sphinx is another one that he's done. And there's a lot of works. A lot of his stuff was medical that he did. And this was a gift he had from childhood. The thing is that the more he used it, the more it would weaken him. But as he got older, he would use it more, you know, which is really crazy. And I will say that, you know, he talked about it being over where they now, you know, they found the Bimini Road, you know, off of Florida, you know, going towards the Bermuda Triangle. And
we just talked about that.
We did. And so, you know, could that be part of it too? Could something have happened and Bermuda Triangle swallowed it up? You know, I mean, we do have some pretty good storms come through there every once in a while.
A lot of swamp gases and methane gases on the bottom of the ocean there.
That's right. A lot of
I bet it was a weather balloon that did it.
Weather balloon crash landed and took out the whole island. I say, come on. Well, I didn't say come on and swim naked. I don't even do that, bird dog. Do you go and I just have a question, bird dog. Do you go to the Tennessee River and go swim? I just want to know, because if so, I need your schedule so I know not to go that day. Just let me know. But, you know, I think that with what he talked about, and as far as Atlantis goes, he had quite a bit of stuff to say about Atlantis, about its sinking, about the people. And, you know, he told a tale pretty similar to what Plato tells, you know, their hubris and everything got so high that they... You know, it was almost like the people who built the Titanic, right? The unsinkable ship. And so, you know, that was their own downfall, was that stuff. Edgar Casey, I think, if I'm not mistaken, he has quite a bit of you know, stuff to say about Atlantis, though.
Yeah.
Astonishing legends. Past lives. You know, that's another thing that he talked about too.
Well, that's what he was saying, that they were incarnating.
Yeah. Reincarnating back as. Yeah. Yeah. But, you know, that just goes right back to what we talked about 100 times as far as reincarnation and all that goes too.
Yeah.
What did he say?
He theorized that the Atlantean civilization. Hold on a minute. migrated to Egypt.
And their knowledge.
And their knowledge of technology cited in the construction of the Great Pyramid.
Well, you know, it gives rise back to the, you know, the whole thing of how were all these things constructed around the world? How are they all very similar in construction and in technique? And, you know, that whole thing with the men holding the handbags that we talked about before.
Mm-hmm.
I really do believe that it does mean knowledge that was passed on by these people that had this knowledge. What else does he say?
He predicted that evidence for Atlantis could be found as far east as the Pyrenees and Morocco and as far west as the Yucatan and Mexico. He also claimed that some significant proof of Atlantis would rise from the depths of its watery grave and make itself known in the year 1968 and 1969. I don't know if that ever happened.
You know, I don't know. I don't remember when Bimini was found, but
the discovery of the enigmatic stone formations beneath the ocean at Bimini in the Bahamas seemed to support his prediction. So, although skeptics claim that the geometric adjoined stone slabs are completely natural formations, believers suspect that the stones were once part of a great Atlantean roadway or temple. According to Casey's readings, the size of Atlantis was equal to that of Europe, and he saw visions of a continent which had gone through three major periods of division. The first two about 15,600 BCE, when the mainland was divided into islands. The three main islands Casey named Pisidia, Og, and Arion. So, he was pretty big on this Atlantis stuff.
Yeah. Yeah, Edgar Casey, he was the man. I think, I don't know. It was funny because that's what I thought I'd remembered was where he made those predictions. And then around that same time, they found Bimini.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody was thinking, oh, we're about to find Atlantis, which, you know, they've never done, but. Yes, Sherry, I believe that. I think that there's always some truth to every legend. And the alien involvement in pyramid building, you know, I'm there with you. I mean, there whether it was aliens themselves, technology of them that they gave or something. What do you think about that, Jason?
I don't think they built it themselves. I mean, they may have, you know, that's just hard to believe, those big old stones.
Well, and then the time period they gave for it to be built doesn't match either.
Yeah, they had to have some kind of help that was far more advanced.
Yeah. Definitely machinery.
Could have been the Atlanteans.
Well, I mean, you know, if they were that high of a civilization, then they could have had the knowledge. And who says that they aren't the aliens?
Yeah.
Who says that that's why they're not here anymore? Maybe they just decided to leave. See ya. Mm-hmm. Peace out. We're done with you. Took their whole island with them. That's why it sank.
So, we're about, oh, let's see, 30 minutes in or a little bit over 30 minutes. We're going to, maybe 45, we're going to take a quick break. And when we come back, We're going to talk some more about Atlantis.
Yes, definitely. Remember, you can find us on Podbean and on Spreaker. We're live, but you could also come to our website, paranormal411.org. Sign up, become a member. It's free. Doesn't cost nothing. Right, Jason?
Free.
You could ask Sherry, anybody, Shell, any of them in the chat room. They'll let you know. And definitely come over to our live show and chat room there at Paranormal 411. Hang out. We're able to do a lot of stuff we can't do in the other ones, like post pictures and stuff. So, you know, hang out with us. And your hosts are Jason and David, and you're listening to Paranormal 411. We'll be back right after this quick break.
Thanks for listening to the show. You can find us on Facebook and Twitter at Paranormal 411. Join us on the website at paranormal411.org. It's free to sign up and become a member. All of our upcoming shows are on the guest and events page. You can also listen to past shows on the website as well. And if you like the show and want to support us, you can do that by becoming a premium member for only $2 a month. Thanks for listening to Paranormal 411. Join us.
In a world on the edge of oblivion, go to paranormal411.org for all of your paranormal, extraterrestrial, and cryptid needs. This is Jeff Reagan of the band Catalyst. Visit Paranormal 411. Click on our link on the right-hand side to listen to or purchase any of our albums on BandLab. We'll be right back.
Well, we're back.
Well.
We just had to play a little bit of Catalyst in some stormy weather because, you know, hey, that might have been what took them out. It was a giant wave, right?
It was a giant something. Maybe the Kraken.
A giant crack. Bird Dog, was you out there swimming? I tell you. Bird Dog says that it's starting to lighten around here. He says, talking about Atlantis is stirring up all the storms. And you know, I left my windows open in my truck.
Uh-oh.
Maybe my wife is listening to this and will be nice enough to go roll my windows up. Or she won't. Well, I've got a pretty cool picture here. Let's see if I can post it into the Facebook, or into, not the Facebook, but into our chat room. Yeah. You can click on it, everybody, and it pops up a really cool map. There you go. Shows where Atlantis was supposed to be, in between North America, South America, and Europe, and Africa.
Mm-hmm.
Like a pretty big place to me. So, you know, we was talking about Edgar Cayce and the Sleeping Prophet. So, it says, Cayce said that the Atlantean society was divided into two long-lived political factions. So it was a good faction called the Sons of the Law of One, and an evil group known as the Sons of Belial.
Belial.
Sounds kind of like Beelzebub or something, doesn't it? But, so he maintained that many people alive today are the reincarnations of Atlantean souls who must now face similar temptations as in their past lives. Cayce said that Atlantis suffered three major destructions, one of which was the deluge. Mm. Bird Dog says, release the crack. He predicted that evidence of Atlantis would be found. You said this off of Bimini. So, let's see. Hold on a second here, because there was a
I got to do it.
Nope.
One more second and I would have.
So some authors also say that India was also an Atlantean colony, and so was Egypt, ancient Egypt. So both of those were actually ancient Atlantean colonies after the destruction of Atlantis. So Professor Santos says that he bases these theories on research in geology, astronomy, paleontology, archaeology, linguistics, ethnology, comparative mythology, comparative religion, and philosophy. So he's basing it on a whole bunch of stuff. And who, he's also a professor of nuclear physics at the Federal University in Brazil. So he struck out very much on his own and come up with a new location for Atlantis, placing it firmly under what is now the South China Sea, maintaining that the Indonesian islands are all that's left. What do you think about that?
Hmm. It's crazy.
Yeah. So he did an answer thing, and someone asked him, is there a connection between Atlantis and the Great Pyramids? He said that the Great Pyramids, indeed, the pyramids world over, represents the Holy Mountain, which is no other than Mount Atlas, the pillar of heaven that was central feature of Atlantis. Mount Atlas was in reality a giant volcano whose explosion destroyed Atlantis, causing the flood and the end of the Pleistocene. In India, this holy mountain, which exists in most tradition is called Mount Meru, the holy mountain of paradise.
Hmm.
That's pretty neat, right?
Yeah.
So, a recent theory put forward by J.M. Allen centers on the Altiplano, an upland plain in Bolivia. He compared Plato's description of the location of Atlantis with physical features found in the Altiplano. He also suggests that they matched Plato's description on almost all points. So another item that Allen gives is Plato's mention of a gold-copper alloy known as orcalium that he maintains is only found in the Andes. Allen also says that the very name Atlantis is derived from two Native American words, atl, meaning water, and antis, meaning copper.
Hmm.
What do you think about that?
That's pretty crazy, too.
Yeah. So recent underwater discoveries off the west coast of Cuba are said to be physical evidence of Atlantis, as well as the undersea ruins found in the Bahamas or the Bimini area. So they also found in the ocean around Japan, underwater pyramids were discovered and photographed in 85. I've seen quite a few documentaries done on those. They're pretty weird. What do you think, Jason?
Mm-hmm.
That's pretty neat, though, right? The Native American words for water and copper?
Yeah.
Huh. I thought that
would be something. You know, Plato wrote three books about Atlantis.
Really?
Yeah, the first two were complete, but the third one was not completed, or he ended it abruptly. He wrote two books about Atlantis. The name of the book was Timaeus, and Critias are the two books.
Okay.
And Critias ends after Zeus, head of the Greek gods, collected all the gods into their most holy habitation, which, being placed in the center of the world, beholds all created things. And when he had called them together, he spake as follows. It ends there. And the book ended.
That's pretty cool.
That's crazy.
It's got me. That's cool. So there's other theories about Atlantis. So not everyone agrees that Atlantis was an island. However, an Irish author and researcher and alternative historian, Michael Tesserian, locates it as part of the ancient continent of Appalachia, where he believes it was the base of an extraterrestrial race referred to in the Bible as the Nephilim. So he says that these beings had been pursued here from elsewhere in the universe. He said that they tried to convince their pursuers that they were on a then-existing water planet of Tiamat, whilst really they were hiding on Earth. This ruse worked, and Tiamat was incinerated and broke up, causing the asteroid belt, as well as having completely devastating effect on the Earth when a large part of its oceans fell to Earth, causing massive deluges.
Mm.
That's something, huh?
Yeah.
Says Atlantis was not a center of advanced human civilizations, but was rather the creation of and home to alien beings that colonized the Earth.
Hmm.
It's an alien colony.
Aliens did it.
I'm not going to leave nothing out because I don't know. I wasn't around then. How about you?
Mm-hmm.
Let's see. They also talk about the Canary Islands. So David Icke, he has a book out called The Children of the Matrix. And he refers to a Neolithic blonde race who lived on the Canary Islands before the Spanish conquest. And he tells us when the European explorers first landed in the Canary Islands, the people said they were descendants of the Atlanteans and were shocked to realize that other people had survived the cataclysm that destroyed their homeland.
Hmm.
Other sources, however, say that the Gaunches were descended from the Berber tribes of North Africa. But even then, there may still be a link because the Berber people that live in the Atlas mountain range having the same root meaning Atlas or Atlantis. I think sometimes people really reach hard
yeah.
for things. And I don't know. I don't buy all of it.
You know, we may never find out if Atlantis was sunken, sank.
Real. But, you know, I think that there is some things in there, don't you? Like, where you have, you know that knowledge was given and passed down. We see signs and symbolisms of it all across the world. Not only in the Americas, but all over Europe and everything else. And when you have certain symbols and things that are passed through different cultures, completely different places on Earth where supposedly, I'm doing air fingers quotes here, supposedly, you know, no one traveled those distances overseas and stuff like that at that time. Then how did they come up with the same iconography?
I don't know.
I just don't buy that. And how do they come up with the same constellations with the same names or the same building types that are built almost identical? Just don't make sense.
There's three things I want to find out.
Let's do it.
What is Atlantis. Well, maybe more than three, maybe four or five. Bigfoot.
Yes.
I believe in ghosts.
Yes.
I do. The golden streets of El Dorado.
Oh, that'd be pretty cool to find El Dorado.
And what's another one? Aliens. Of course, I believe in aliens, too.
Well, we're finding out more and more that our government believes in them, too.
You know, I think that we have a lot of evidence that they should just come out and say it. I mean, just like with Bigfoot, there's all kinds of evidence there they're not even wanting to recognize.
Mm-hmm.
Hair samples. Even the, you know, the DNA samples.
Yep.
But they say, oh, no, it's just unknown.
Yep.
Hmm.
I think that we are a species with amnesia. That we do not remember our true origins. So we make up fancy little tales. To give ourselves purpose and meaning. And, hey, if you're happy with that, I'm okay with that too. But I think, like you said, I don't think we're ever going to know now.
No.
Not in this, you know, corporeal body. I don't think so. It's not like you could find them, raise them up, and talk to them. Maybe everybody needs to go through past life regressions and try to find their Atlantean self. that was just a joke, everybody.
Bird Dog would be Aquaman in his past life.
He'd be release the Kraken.
Release the Kraken.
I don't know. I believe it was a place, and there's just too many stories, and things that say that there was this place that existed.
Well, they found one mythical city that sank. Helic, is that the name of it? It was a Greek city that sank under the water. Shares every bit of Atlantis's mythical power. And they found it. According to the Greek myth, Helic was destroyed by the wrath of God, Poseidon. The city's residents had driven the Lonian tribe, who were loyal worshippers of the god of the sea, out of the city. In his fury, Poseidon pulled the whole city under the water in a single night.
Well, it sounds a lot like the tale, doesn't it?
Yeah, and 373 BC is when that city sank. And in the late 1980s, two archaeologists started a quest to track it down. It took them more than a decade, but they found it.
So don't give up. We still maybe find it.
Oh, yeah.
There's people out there looking for it.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not something that people have stopped looking for by any means. So... you have this person right here that says, there have been many structures that remain enigmatic, predating unknown civilizations, 200-plus ton stones in Peru, Lebanon, plus stonework in Morocco, similar to the outsourced stonework in Peru. This person's done research and has uncovered proof of Atlantis-like event in 9620 BC, and have three pieces of evidence. Each of them differ from a different field of science, but all point to the same date, and none of them point directly to Atlantis, but Plato's Lost Island remains the likeliest suspect, since it supposedly subsided about 9600 BC. And one of those items involves a worldwide drop in sea levels by 2 meters, consistent with an Atlantis-sized landmass going under the water. That's something, right?
Yeah. Atlantis.
You know, a lot of people just believe that it's a made up tale to tell you, you know, to live your life right and don't do these things. And
I don't know. I mean, what purpose would it be for a tale like that? I mean, it's not telling you anything to do or.
No, there's no Ten Commandments.
There's nothing that you would gain by being like Atlanteans.
Well, and that's what they're, I think that's what the tale supposedly by these people are saying, right? If you live like these people, you act like these people, then you will have a downfall like these people. But all nations fall given time.
Yep.
Ask the Romans.
Ask the Krishna.
That's right. Hare Krishna.
Oh, well,
the devil made me do it.
I think we're about at the end.
Yeah.
What do you think? Well, you got anything else?
I mean, another one that I thought you was going to talk about a minute ago, but, you know, they thought Troy was a myth. And they found Troy. So, I think... I think that if we keep looking, that they could maybe find it, depending on, again, where it is, right? If it is past the Straits of Gibraltar and right and all that stuff. And I don't know.
It may be in a galaxy far, far away, controlled by the Wraith.
Oh, yeah. They're mean.
Yes.
They're like. Then you can jump onto a ship that just travels the universe.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Oh, yeah.
Again, we're talking about Stargate Atlantis. sorry. But if you've watched it, it's Stargate Atlantis was pretty good.
Yeah.
It was better than the one that came right after it, Stargate Universe. I don't think it even lasted two seasons, did it? Two or three seasons?
I think four.
Was it? Wow. That's longer than
three or four.
People stuck with that, trying to hope it would actually do something.
Then, I mean, it was good up until a certain point, till everybody started possessing everybody.
Huh. I want to possess you. And they're getting into demonology, huh? I think that we do know that there was a deluge, and everybody could have their own opinions about it, and there's some pretty good books about what really caused the deluge, and those books. Or the book that I've read, which is a really good book, gives the reason for it, and that we still pass through it every year. I mean, we pass through the torrid meteor showers every year, and that there's still huge chunks floating out there that just hasn't come screaming back down and hit us to cause any more chaos. But, you know, it's something that definitely did hit and caused a lot of catastrophes, and may be the reason we don't have Atlantis anymore. But it was somewhere, you know, what did they say, Jason? Something like 15,000 years ago.
Atlantis would be 11,500 years.
Yeah. So, and it was about 12,000 years ago, somewhere right around there, when that hit and caused the deluge. Bam. I think so. I mean, what does anyone else in the Sherry or anybody in the chat rooms, what do y'all think? What do you think about Atlantis? Do you think that it's real? Do you think it's made up? Do you think it's somehow a story that was told to get people to live better?
Mm-hmm.
Maybe. Right? They were half gods and half humans.
Demigods.
Demigods. I don't know. I think it's possible. You know, we never did talk about the Atlanteans and the extraterrestrial connection. Sherry says she thinks it existed.
Bird Dog says he does too.
Bird Dog thinks.
That's unusual.
Wow, that is. Huh. I like it.
Well, tell us about the extraterrestrials.
So, some stories claim that the original inhabitants of the Lost City are believed to be of extraterrestrial origin who reached there about 50,000 years ago from the Lyran star system.
The what?
Yes, exactly. The Lyra from Lyrian.
Lyrian.
Lyrian star system. Let's see. What if it was aliens and the city was actually a craft?
Oh, Jerry, that's the show.
That's the show. I think that it's possible, though. I really do think that it is possible that they just decided to say, okay, whoop, we're done, and took off.
Now and she's blew away. She's seen it before, right? I would hope that's what it is, really.
So despite being taller and fairer than today's average humans, the average lifespan of these people are believed to be somewhere between 800, 900 years.
What does that suggest?
Making them really robust and strong prototype of the existing human race.
Where do we get 800 and 900 year old people?
Yep, from the Bible.
Yeah.
You get
Methuselah was 900 and something.
Yep. Yep, Abraham was supposed to be something like 800 or something, wasn't
he? Yeah.
So, no, she hasn't seen the show. You know, Sherry, I believe the same thing. I think that that is a really strong possibility, too. I really do think it's a strong possibility. I think that's where the show got it from, was from one of those possibilities. I don't know. I think that it could be. Maybe. So some claim that the lost city of Atlantis was on Mars. And the inhabitants of the Atlantis city are believed to have be possessors of exceptional powers, such as the ability to control the weather, modify volcanic eruptions, and so they also supposedly have some sort of device that allowed them to channel energy from time and space.
Time travel.
Us from the very far future.
Yep.
So they just portaled their city in and out. They phased it in and phased it back out.
Mm-hmm.
Right? That would be kind of cool. So even though the myth says that the inhabitants of Atlantis were superior beings, there are some of the opinions that it's just a mythical representation of a barbaric fashion of life. I don't know. Join us. So some people, like Robert Ballard, finds logic in the story, as it has similarities to a massive volcanic eruption on the island of Santorini in the Aegean Sea near Greece. So he said the highly advanced society lived there, disappeared suddenly, as happened with the Atlantean people. Similarly, Donnelly also confirms the existence and disappearance of a mid-Atlantic continent that was in the exact location that Plato mentioned. So he thinks it's part of Santorini. And a professor at Bard College in New York says Plato himself created the story in order to convey some of his philosophical theories, mostly about his visions of an ideal civilization.
Bird Dog says the Nephilim might have lived on Atlantis.
I think it's very possible because they were said to be giants, very tall people. So, I think that is definitely possible, too. Like I said, I don't think that you could dismiss any one thing. What do you think?
No.
What'd you throw up in the chat room, Jason?
A couple of pictures.
That's a pretty picture.
That's Atlantis.
Oh, yeah. Stargate Atlantis. Boy, it's been a long time since I've seen that. And it's got Jason Momoa, doesn't it?
Yeah.
I didn't realize he was in there. Is he an Atlantean?
No, he was from the other galaxy. Right,
because those people had him implanted, and he was fighting them, wasn't he? He was like a.
They was like chasing him, yeah, yes, as a game.
Yes, that's right. Because they caught him, and then they took the tracker thing out of him, didn't they? Mm-hmm. I remember now.
Yeah. I'm gonna have to go home and start watching it.
But yeah, that was pretty good. Stargate Atlantis was pretty good. It got a little corny towards the end, so I stopped watching it.
Come on, Aldo.
Hey, I got through one season, literally one season of Stargate Universe and never watched another episode. I was like, I'm done. Now they're just throwing crap out. Gates throughout the universe. Hasn't had people on it for so long that it don't even hardly have oxygen on it. It's crazy. So, Jason, we have a couple of announcements, don't we, that you need to make?
Do I?
Yeah.
What about... Oh, I'm sorry, I'm pregnant.
Jason's pregnant, everybody.
I feel like I am.
6 months.
After I eat that Mexican food today.
No, we have a book.
Oh, we do have a book. It's a little book. Hey, but it's a book.
It's pretty cool, though. We've got, yes, a 5-star rating on that little book.
Yeah, 5 stars on Amazon.
Yeah. And what else? What's coming up that we're going to?
Oh, we have the Smoky Mountain Bigfoot Conference coming up on July 23rd.
And you have two tickets
you're giving away. Got two tickets to give away. How are we going to give these away?
Well, we gotta come up with a way. We need people to be listening live.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, all they have to do is win. And tell us they're actually going to come, or at least try their dangdest to come. We send the, all we have to do is send them the, we can send it to them over the email, can't we? Or do we have to print them out?
No, I can send it to email.
And then you can print them out yourself. When you go, you show them, and it actually says Paranormal 411 guests. It's Two tickets to paradise,
to the biggest Bigfoot conference.
I love it. We got some pretty good people this year.
If you like Expedition Bigfoot, they're going to be there.
Yes. And boy, the last few episodes was good this year.
Yes.
Especially when that thing that he thought was a bear stood up and started walking off. You're like, oh, he's got a Bigfoot. It was fantastic. Does it smell good, Jay?
Yeah. Also, the shadows that they caught.
Yes.
The shadow people.
That was weird.
Yes.
That was very weird. They caught that twice, too, didn't they?
Mm-hmm.
So, now there's some pretty corny stuff that happened, too, though, that I'll have to say that. They try a little too hard in some areas. But luckily, it seems like there's a couple of them there on the show that just won't even go there. So that's why I still watch it. But it sounds like this next year they're going, or this next season, they're going to be going to Alaska.
Yep.
So I think that'd be pretty cool.
Mm-hmm.
So, but definitely if you want to.
So who wants to win Bigfoot?
Yes, win tickets. Bigfoot tickets and comes check us out and check out the awesome lineup of guests that they've got this year. Definitely let us know, but we're going to have to do something. I don't know. Do we need to play a game, or we haven't played our game in a long time.
We could do a trivia.
Yeah, we have our game. Remember, we've done that a couple of times. That was pretty fun.
Yeah.
First one that answers 3 questions wins.
Mm-hmm.
I think that'd be fun. But we need to do it probably sometime next month. First week or so.
Yeah.
So
first week in July.
Yeah. So we're going to do that. So definitely stay tuned. And if you want and are able to come to the Smoky Mountain Bigfoot Conference, let us know. And we'll try to set you up with playing the game and see if you can win some tickets. Because who won them last year loved it, didn't they?
Yeah.
So, matter of fact, we even had a couple of extra tickets to give away last year, didn't we?
Mm-hmm.
On top of the tickets we had to give away. So, but we had a good time going to be. What? I don't know. That's a very incomplete sentence.
Bird dog?
Bird dog.
Going to be buying your book.
Woo! Well, thank you.
Heck yeah.
Thank you. It has a story that you should know a little bit about, Bird Dog, on there.
Yeah.
So.
It does.
Wiz talked about it the other day. Out of all the stories, there's 4 that are pretty personal, that are local to this area, too. So. Isn't that right? 4 of them. So, it's pretty cool. And, but yeah, definitely check out the book. You go on Amazon, you can type in Jason Scott or David Reagan and it'll pop up, or you could type in the name of the book.
East Tennessee Hauntings and Lore.
Yes. It's a pretty cool book. It's a really pretty book.
Yeah. The Kindle wouldn't do it. Do you justice? You need to have the book. It's pretty neat.
If you want to hurry up and read it, you could buy the Kindle, but I would say the book is like awesome. So, but yeah, definitely check it out. It's pretty cool. Sherry. But anything else, Jason, that we're missing?
I think that's it.
I do want to thank Catalyst East Tennessee for letting us play their music. And we're happy that Sherry's able to come back. It's been a while. And glad to see you back in there. Bird Dog, you're there every week. But we still appreciate you. we appreciate everybody that comes in, listens during the live shows or, you know, during the podcast. You know, we're very grateful and happy to have, you know, people listening to us and tuning in and everything. And so remember, you are listening to Paranormal 411. Your hosts are Jason Scott and David Reagan. And we will see you next week, right, Jason? No, no, we will not. Sorry, everybody.
Maybe if you drive at night.
Because I probably won't be home till about Sunday of next week, if I'm lucky. Sunday of next week.
You driving during the day or during the night?
Yeah, it'll be daytime driving because I'm leaving out Sunday morning, like 8-9 o'clock in the morning. So, and this just decided not to work on me now. Oh, there we go. So remember, have a good night. We won't be on air next week unless we do a Sunday show, which I don't know how we're going to do that because Jason's got to work. So. We'll see. We'll talk about it. But maybe we could do a show during the week or something.
Oh, yeah.
So, everybody, have a good night. Bye, Sherry.
Bye.
Bye, Bird Dog and Shell and everybody that's in the chat rooms. And we will definitely talk to you later.
Thanks for listening to the show. You can find us on Facebook and Twitter at Paranormal411. Join us on the website at paranormal411.org. It's free to sign up and become a member. All of our upcoming shows are on the guest and events page. You can also listen to past shows on the website as well. And if you like the show and want to support us, you can do that by becoming a premium member for only $2 a month. Thanks for listening to Paranormal 411. Join us.